name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, we're going to observe a gas-forming reaction. For our materials, we're going to use some magnesium ribbon that is pre-cut into fairly small pieces. We're also going to use a 3-molar hydrochloric acid solution. And then we will need some water, but not as a reagent. Rather, you'll see how we're going to find a creative use for it. For our equipment, we will need a 100 milliliter graduated cylinder, and this can be made of plastic or glass. It doesn't matter, but it should be as large as possible. We'll also need a tub or a very large beaker filled with water. This can be tap water, it doesn't matter what it is. We'll need a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder, a scale, a weighing boat, a large test tube. We'll also need a rubber tubing connected to a glass tubing, to a rubber stopper, and this rubber stopper needs to be of appropriate size to fit into our large test tube. And then finally, we will need to collect the temperature of the water, and that means we're going to need a thermometer. And that's here. So let's begin our experiment. First, we are going to take our 100 milliliter graduated cylinder. We're going to fill it up all the way with water. I'm doing this on top of the tub of water because if any of this water drips over, it will be caught. Then I am going to take my hand, place it right on top of the graduated cylinder, hold it down, turn it upside down, and then slide my hand under the water so that when I release it, hopefully there will be no air bubbles. If there are, we begin again. And this time there were just a few. I fill up the graduated cylinder again with water all the way to the brim. Prepare my hand. Turn it upside down. Slide it under water. And then I release. And this way there are no bubbles. Right. That is one part of our setup. Now we are done with this water and we can set it aside. For the next thing, I will need dry hands, so I will wipe my gloves off. I will take my scale, remove the lid, turn it on, place the weighing boat on top of it, press tear, and then I will measure out between 0.06 and 0.08 grams of magnesium ribbon. It is best to err on the side of less rather than more. And if you have an analytical balance that gives you more decimal places than my little scale, please go ahead and use that one. And I measured out 0.07 grams of magnesium ribbon. I will set this aside for the moment and put away my scale. Next, I am going to measure 5 milliliters of my 3-molar hydrochloric acid solution. It is okay if we use a little bit more. It doesn't have to be exact, but we should know how much of the 3-molar hydrochloric acid solution we used. So we record the volume at eye level. I have 5.28 milliliters of my hydrochloric acid. Now we assemble the other part of the experiment. First, we're going to take our glass tubing. We're going to bring in our tub a little closer. And we're going to slide the rubber hose right under our graduated cylinder. You can pull up your graduated cylinder just a little bit, but make an effort not to pull it above the water level because at that point it will release the water that you so carefully filled into the graduated cylinder. So now again, my hands are wet. You need to dry it. For the next part, this is going to be easy. We take our hydrochloric acid solution and we try to pour it into the test tube so that it doesn't touch the walls of the test tube. Once it is transferred, we move on to the addition of our magnesium strips. We take our test tube, we turn it sideways, we take our magnesium shavings and we place it on the walls of the test tube so that it doesn't go all the way to the bottom and doesn't react with the hydrochloric acid until we are ready to capture the gas that is formed in the process. We close the connection between the rubber stopper and the test tube. And when we are ready and we make sure that the rubber hose is still under the graduated cylinder, then we turn our test tube and we allow our magnesium strips to go into the hydrochloric acid solution and react. You should see gas formation in your graduated cylinder. And if you have any magnesium ribbons on the side, you should make an effort to get them to react with the hydrochloric acid solution. You will know that your reaction is over when all your magnesium ribbons have been consumed and the bubbling stops in your test tube. You may shake your test tube, but it is really important that you don't move your rubber tubing too much so that it doesn't get out from under the graduated cylinder. I have a little bit more magnesium in my test tube, so I will wait a little longer. The resulting solution should be colorless because magnesium chloride is a white powder which produces a colorless solution. And that is what we see here. The magnesium ribbons are gone, the bubbling stopped, and this indicates that our reaction is complete. Now at this point, I can remove my rubber tubing from under the graduated cylinder. And just to check whether the reaction is exothermic or endothermic, we can gently touch the bottom of the test tube. It's quite hot, so this was a rather exothermic process. We can disconnect, set our tubing to the side. Our test tube's content, we'll need to check the pH. If it is within the acceptable range, it can be discarded down the drain. Otherwise, we'll need to neutralize it and then discard it down the drain. And finally, the measurements for our gas. The first measurement will be that of volume. We're going to gently raise the graduated cylinder just above the water level, and we're going to record the volume of the gas. It is a good thing that I am using a 100 milliliter graduated cylinder because the volume of the produced gas is 99.9 milliliters. So I was very, very close. If your reaction produced a little over 100 milliliters, restart your reaction so that you can capture the produced gas's volume accurately. So first, we have the volume of the gas that we produced, and that is in our graduated cylinder. The second thing that we need to know about our gas is its temperature. So for that, we're going to use our thermometer. The temperature of the gas will be the same as the temperature of the water through which it passed and on top of which it was collected. To record that temperature, we take our thermometer, slide it into our tub of water, give it about a minute, and then we will record the temperature. The temperature of my water is 22.3 degrees Celsius. So I have volume, I have temperature. The pressure of the gas that we will need to determine its number of moles will be the same as the atmospheric pressure of the room, and that is usually the same as the atmospheric pressure that is outside. So you may check your weather forecast. It will tell you the atmospheric pressure of that day on which you perform the experiment. Additionally, if you have a barometer in your classroom, you may record the pressure of the room that way. From these three values, you should be able to determine the moles of the hydrogen gas that you collected above water. But keep in mind, some of the gas that you collected is going to be water vapor at the temperature at which your water is currently at.